What's up, folks at home? I just got this present in the mail. Fragile? Must be Italian. Looks like there's a note. Now I'm coming for your present. Ho, ho, ho. We gotta protect our mom's present.
Analog alarm.
Alright folks, so what we're gonna need for this project is an LM386, an NPN transistor, a speaker, some capacitors and resistors, a 9-volt battery, and something to make a switch out of. Our circuit is based on a Texas Instruments design for a 1 kHz square wave oscillator. Apparently someone else got this circuit to work as is, but I wasn't so lucky. But I found out that inserting a diode right here does the trick. That's not even in the anywhere in the script. When the president is on top of it, it creates a closed switch. If the object is removed, the oscillator becomes active and generates a square wave that can be used to produce an extremely annoying sound using an ordinary speaker. First, we take the op amp and add positive feedback. Now we have a bistable multivibrator, which means that the circuit's output will always end up in one of two stable states, either saturation at the positive rail or saturation at the negative rail. But when the output reaches one of the stable states, it'll just stay there. We need an output that repeatedly switches back and forth between the two stable states. To accomplish this, we add negative feedback in the form of a resistor capacitor circuit. The circuit will now change states repeatedly as the voltage across the capacitor increases or decreases following an output transition. Our circuit is now an astable multivibrator because it has no stable output state. We control the oscillator by using an NPN transistor as a power supply switch. When the transistor is in cutoff, the op amp's negative supply terminal is disconnected from ground. I almost had it. Disconnected from ground. When the BJT is not in cutoff, the op amp has a current path to ground, and this enables the oscillator circuit. The two leads are shorted together via the exposed strip on the bottom of the present. And you gotta have... It has to be firmly pressed down on the switch. With both base and emitter at 0 volts, the BJT is in cutoff and will not allow current to flow from collector to emitter. Removing the short between the two exposed leads connects the BJT's base directly to 9 volts. This brings the BJT out of cutoff and activates the oscillator by allowing current to flow from collector to emitter. Oh no. What does this guy do? That's just like a mildly irritating sound. Does he think I'm a dog?